Mommy Briar? Huh? There isn't any food anywhere.
Oh,
and if Bramble ever got his lazy bones out of bed. Huh? An egg? Oh yeah, lunchtime. Huh?
Mama!
Mama! You think I'm your mama?
Mama! Mama! Mama!
No. I'm not your mama. I'm just a very hungry bear.
Huh? Hungry? Ooh, hungry, hungry!
That's right, that's right. Looking for food. Gotta get going.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Huh? Stop following me!
All right!
See? That wasn't so hard. I am not your mama! Do you understand? Stop saying that!
I understand!
Briar! Man! You look exhausted! Did you have a run-in with Vic or something?
No. It's just, nothing. It's nothing. Bramble, I'm tired. I need to rest.
My gut tells me there's something wrong with Briar.
How did he find me?
Who's that? Sounds like someone's looking for mommy. Who's there? No one's here. I could have sworn I heard someone. Huh?
Hello, excuse me. Can you please help me find my mama?
Your mom? She's not here. Briar?
Mama!
Briar, are you really this duck's mom?
Mama!
When will you get it through your cute face? I am not your mama. Look at you. You don't look anything like me. I'm a strong, dashing bear. See these muscles? Huh? See that? Look, I'm ripped. See? Now look at you. You will never be strong like me. Stop following me.
My mama doesn't want me because I'm too weak. One day, I will be big and strong, just like mama.
Huh? Look at all this fruit.
Mama, I need breakfast.
What? You found all this fruit? All by yourself?
Hey, Briar, I think you are going to make a great mom.
Get out of my face.
Why doesn't my mama like me?
What's wrong with that duck? Why does he think I'm his mom?
Mama!
Stay strong. Delicious. You know what, Briar? I think you'll make a great parent. And look at him, ain't he cute? And he'll help us around the house. We couldn't ask for a better kid. what do you think?
Enough! I am a bear, not the mother of some confused little duck.
But you'd be so good at it. Huh?
You like him so much, you be his mother.
Hey, bro, wait up!
Well, isn't this a lovely day off? I should really call my mom. A baby duck?
Look, here's some more fruit!
Hey, bro, wait for me!
Huh? Logger Vic?
Oh, no! Vic's after the duck! You don't think he's gonna turn our little buddy into roast duck?
What? Roast duck? Listen to me. We gotta save that duck from Logger Vic. But the duck can't see us. He'll only think I'm his mom. Got it? Come on, think, Briar.
Almost got him. What are the bears doing here?
Oh boy, the jig is up.
Maybe they're hunting that poor duckling. Not on my watch. Who's there?
Here.
Oh, why, thank you. Baby ducky. Now's my chance. So you want a race, do ya? Bring it on! I'm too fast for ya, aren't I?
Victory! Yeah!
Stop!
Where'd the little duck go? Where is he? Not here.
Bramble. Bramble. Wake up, Bramble. Bramble!
My head feels funny.
You just sneezed and chucked Vic into the lake. He almost had the duck. And then you came and boom!
Really? So our little duck is safe then?
Of course he's safe. Look!
I got you, little ducky. Let's be getting home now.
Briar.
Baby duck, I promise to save you from Logger Vic's evil clutches.
Yeah.
We need a plan to get the duck from Vic's evil clutches.
What do you have in mind?
When we get to Logger Vic's house, you need to draw his attention. Then I sneak in and save our ducky.
I'm worried about the little duck. Do you think Vic will force him to do his chores? Or maybe lock him up and starve him? Maybe Vic will turn him into duck soup. The poor little guy.
It's just your imagination. Let's go save our duck.
Okay.
Look at that.
The duck was injured. And Vic wrapped up the wound.
Say hello to your mommy.
Oh, my baby. Come to Mama. Thank you so much.
What a wonderful thank you that was. My pleasure.
That whole time, Logger Vic just wanted to reunite a baby with his mother.
Who thought Logger Vic was such a softie?
Hoo-hoo's new friend.
Help yourself to some watermelon, guys. Hey, Hoo Hoo, you gotta come try this.
No thanks, owls don't eat that.
Oh. Alrighty. Hello, Moonie. Hello, Starry. Tonight, my friends, I be making poem.
My sire is the best.
He hasn't even made a poem yet. I'll be the judge of that when he does.
Good boy, Babu. Under the lighting of the moon, with a watermelon and a spoon, and a merry little toad.
Now that's a good poem.
At least he made it rhyme.
Hey, guys. Can I sing you a little song? What do you say?
Sure.
Go ahead.
In the silent forest, I see the moon.
Even though Hoo-Hoo singing very, very goodly, hearing it every day makes me want to go away. It is driving us all crazy.
Guys, let's go. It's time for bed.
The sunlight is on its... You guys never wait until the end of the song. Don't you know that's rude? You guys... I feel so sad. Who are you? Would you like to sing with me? Huh? Really? In the silent forest, I see the moon.
Bro, we left before the end. Do you think she'll be mad at us?
I could not be taking it anymore.
Finally, the owl's done. She's been singing every single night, and I've got a headache because of her. Ha! Time to get working!
In the silent forest, I see the moon.
No way.
It
Isn't this a bit late to be singing?
Lovely ground. Huh? Hi there, Lagervik. Pardon me. The thing is, me and my friend have a singing date later. So if you don't like the song, maybe you'd better leave. It shines down onto the lovely ground.
I'll never get any work done with that racket.
Sleeping flowers dance.
What is being wrong with the Hoo-Hoo? Maybe she be knocking her head on something.
Huh?
You didn't know? She was telling us all.
A new boyfriend?
That's right. And guess what? We have so many things in common, and every night we sing together. And guys, he has beautiful eyes. They glow at nighttime.
Are you serious?
Of course I am. He likes singing as much as I do. And even though we've never actually met, he seems to know everything I'm thinking. I was feeling so lonely before, but now I don't think I've ever been happier than this.
I'll never be seeing another owl here before. That Hoo-Hoo is crazy.
It shines down onto the lovely ground.
Ouchie. That was close, huh? Oh, yeah, all right. Who's there? This place is strange. Kind of creepy. Hello? Anyone there? I can hear you. Could it have been the rocks just talking to me now? That one's talking there! I figured it out. I bet that owl thought these sounds were her friends. Aha! If I use these stones to catch the owl, I'll be able to work in peace again.
I have amazing news! My mysterious singing friend has invited me to meet him!
What?
Is this really true?
Mm-hmm. It happened last night. I see the moon.
Hello! Can you hear me? Since we've been singing together for a long time now, don't you think it's about time we meet for real?
Oh, really? I'd love to meet.
Me too.
I'm excited.
So tomorrow we'll meet. You can come to my house. What do you say?
Oh, perfect. See you tomorrow then.
Don't you think that sounds pretty unlikely?
For sure. I don't think I like this.
As I am being the king of the forest, I want you to be a bit more realistic. There is no other owl.
Huh? He is real, and he wants to meet me.
I cannot be believing you. Unless you be bringing him here to meeting us.
Huh. Okay, then.
I think maybe we're taking this too far.
Our first date. I better make sure I look beautiful. I get to meet my new friend so soon. I can't wait. I can't help but wonder what he might look like. I hope he likes me. Huh? Oh no, I've forgotten the gift I made. I better go get it.
What happened?
Now you know, he's not real.
He is real. I'm injured because I hit a tree. Oh, but just look at me now, guys. I can't meet him like this. Would you guys please do me a favor? Could you please go meet him and tell him why I can't make it? Oh, please help me, guys.
Well.
Right, we'll do it.
Thanks so much.
Hello, Hoo-Hoo's friend.
Hello.
We're friends with Hoo-Hoo. Are you there?
I've never seen this place before.
Hey, Boo-Boo, you made it. I've been waiting.
What?
Whoa!
I'm the guy who's been singing with you.
Wow! Hoo-Hoo's new friend is handsome.
You aren't Hoo-Hoo.
Oh, it's okay. We're Hoo-Hoo's friend.
Hoo-Hoo's friend, please don't be mad at us.
Hoo-Hoo got injured, so she can't make it. She asked us to come tell you.
Yeah.
Poor Hoo-Hoo.
Something is not right in here.
Are you? Who was that talking?
I don't know. Tiki?
Who's friend? Are you okay?
Hey! Lagervik!
Uh-oh!
Tricking the Hoo-Hoo! Guys, coming over here!
Oh no! Hoo-Hoo's new friend got hurt!
Oh no! We better go check! Lagervik? Hoo-Hoo's new friend! What happened to you, little guy? Are you okay? What the? What am I gonna do, Briar? His wings fell off!
Okay, that owl being in a bust, Lagervik make it.
If it's not a real owl, then what were those songs Hoo-Hoo heard?
Well, I know, I know.
Huh?
But if I tell you, you can't blame me. Those are my terms. You can take it or leave it.
Deal. Go ahead.
Let me explain myself to you. On these hot summer nights, at a specific time, the wind changes direction and it blows from a certain angle through all of these holes. And that's how all the funky sounds are made.
Through the holes?
Pretty cool, huh? See ya!
You getting back here?
Tiki, just leave it. We're not here for that. Now we know where the sounds came from. And when Hoo-Hoo mentioned his beautiful eyes, I guess it was those fireflies.
Briar, I don't think we should tell Hoo-Hoo about this.
You wanting to lying?
It's not a lie. I just want her to have this lovely memory.
No matter how lovely it is still fake.
Who cares? At least Hoo-Hoo won't get broken-hearted.
So we let her go on living in some sort of fantasy world that we're making up.
All right, you guys, cut it out.
Do you even have a heart in that empty chest under your
seat? She needed to know the truth.
Huh?
Briar!
We need to come up with a story that won't hurt Hoo-Hoo. We're sorry, Hoo-Hoo. He had to leave.
Oh, well, that's a pity.
Oh, that's right. He said he wants to see the world, so he's taking a flight tonight.
Yeah, that's right. And he gave us this gift for you.
Yes, it is true. He'd be saying that he'd be coming back to visiting you very soon.
Oh, I'll wait for him. My friend, have a nice trip.
A gift from the forest.
Got a dang old letter for Logger Vic. Letter for Logger Vic. Logger Vic. You have a letter. Open up, Logger Vic.
All right, all right. I'm coming. Huh? Huh? Oh, so rude. Wake me up, then run off. What's this? It's addressed to me. I'm surprised people still use the postal system. Let's see what it says. Dear sir or ma'am, nice touch, formal. I am happy you received this letter. I have lived in the city my whole life.
I have always wanted to go to the forest and spend time in nature's beauty. Unfortunately, I'm confined to a wheelchair and I fear my dream may never come true. I wanted to ask if you could send me something from the forest. Thank you very much. Yours, Carl.
Poor kid. I've got to send him something to make him happy. But what? What can I send him? I'll send him a postcard with a picture of the forest on it. Look at these ones. Hey, man, how much for this one?
80 cents.
80? That's too much. Excuse me. I've got to check to see how much money I've got left. 60, 70, and 3. 73 cents. Not enough. Sorry, man. Maybe next time. Hand painting's more meaningful. Oh, yeah. Ah, boy. Not exactly a forest, though. I don't know what to do. I've got to think of something. Come on. But what else can I do? That'll do it. All right. Hello, baby. Open with caution. My favorite comic book when I was a child. And there it is. He's most definitely gonna like this. All right, who could that be? Oh, Vic here.
Vicky, this is Mom.
Hi, Ma. Oh, it's great to hear from you. How you doing?
I'm okay, but I miss you. It's been months since the last time you called us.
I'm so sorry. I've been working, Mom.
I remember our neighbor's son, Frank. He's busy, but always visits his parents.
My cutout.
My little Vicky, we really care about you.
Come back.
Vicky, honey, are you still with me?
Get back here. Wait.
Bramble, catch.
They look so beautiful and juicy, don't they?
What can I say? When it comes to fruits, I'm sort of a genius.
Get it off me.
Briar. Bro, are you okay?
My head. What happened? Huh? What's this? Is it just pink?
Beautiful! Brian, let me look.
No, you don't.
Let me look at it, bro.
Your clumsy hands may break it.
I just want to look
at it. No,
I
said no.
Brian!
Bramble, look there. Is that honey?
Honey? Where is it? I see any honey. Huh? Oh, where'd it go?
Let's see. This is incredible. Wow. Amazing.
Where'd it go? I've got to find it. Where in heck could it be?
So cool.
It's Briar. I wonder what he's holding. That's my cutout in his hand.
Thank goodness he found it for me.
Hey, Briar!
Huh? Logger Vic? Huh? What's going on?
Nothing much. Thank you for finding my paper cutout. Can I have it back?
Huh? I have no idea what you're talking about.
Huh? But I saw you with it! Give it back to me! Oh, Briar!
Whoa. Stop! Fine. I admit that I just found it. But you can't prove that it's actually yours.
That is called a paper cutout.
A cutout?
Right. Pretty, isn't it? My mother taught me when I was just a boy. I got a letter from a young lad who wants to see the forest. But alas, he lives in the city, and he's in a wheelchair. I thought that paper cutout would be a really good present for him. It has people, the forest, and animals on it. But then it blew away. Briar, will you give it back to me? Please?
Here.
Great!
Hang on. I need you to make a promise. You'll quit logging.
Well...
How about that?
All right, Briar. You have my word.
Here.
Thank you. Thank goodness.
Yeah! Yeah, I got it!
Uh-oh.
I'm so sorry! I didn't know it meant so much to you! I didn't mean to destroy it! Briar, what am I gonna do? Hey, Vic, I'll give you something else to make it up to you.
Hey, Briar, do we have anything?
I don't know.
There. It's all my fault! I shouldn't have ruined it! I'm such a loser!
Hey, bears, I figured out what to do for the kid now.
Wow, I sure can pick him.
When I was young, my mom also taught me how to cut leaves. She picked colorful ones and cut out different shapes to make a barbola. It's gonna be so gorgeous.
Those scissors. These things are so sharp. Bramble, this isn't a toy. You could hurt yourself. By the way, how do we make a barbola?
I forgot. You guys haven't done this before. Right, I'll teach you how to cut the leaves. Huh? Alrighty, just watch me. We'll cut it into shape, like so.
This is fun.
Oh, be careful. Don't hurt yourselves, okay?
I'll have a try. There. Huh. Needs more cuts.
Yeah.
Okay, the barbola is done.
Am I dreaming? I can't believe we made such a beautiful barbola.
Look, Vic, you're the hero.
Yes, you are.
Well, thank you. Hey, but we did it together. This barbola we made of the leaves in the forest demonstrates the beauty of nature. It's wonderful. It'll make him feel like he's here. It's like the best gift ever.
Yeah, that's right. This is the best gift ever. I bet he'll be super happy when we give it to him.
Let's go send it right now.
Ooh. I sure hope he likes it.
Relax. Of course he'll like it.
Briar Bramble! Come on!
Who's that? Huh? Logger Vic? What's got you so worked up this morning?
Vic, you haven't gotten enough sleep yet.
Hey, he wrote back.
Really? The boy from the city wrote back?
Really? Read it to me!
Dear Uncle Vic, Briar, and Bramble, I've received your gift from the forest. I love it so much. The barbola looks great. It really takes me to the forest. It's like I'm there. With this barbola, I can imagine what the forest looks like. I can even smell it. This is the most special gift ever. All my friends love it too. Thank you, Uncle Vic, Briar, and Bramble.
It's so touching.
We made his dream come true. It feels good to help. We should be happy.
Yeah, we should keep making barbola, shouldn't we? Letting all the kids know how beautiful the forest is.
what do you say? Shall we do it?
Yes, please!
Great idea, Vic. Let's do it!
Yeah, yay! I'll do the design!
Crunch it, Chewie!
Finally on time for a change. Oh, I'm all pooped out and totally tired. I can hardly wait to get home, so I can sleep for a week. Ouch, that smarts. Whoa. Oh no, there's still one more log left. The train. It left. Oh well, I'll ship it next time. I haven't slept that good in years. Oh, my poor sofa! And my wood! Oh no! What's going on here? There's only one answer. It's those stinking bears and they've gone too far! Time to settle this. They wouldn't know what hit them.
Logger Vic, why are you here?
Don't be acting all innocent!
Briar, what is he talking about?
Don't patronize me! It was you! I know it!
Huh? What did I do? Well, let's see. I went to the bathroom, and then I ate an apple, and then I ate some honey.
Enough! Cut to the chase! Now, who's covering my loss?
Huh? Your loss? What loss?
Don't play games with me! Look!
Huh?
Here's proof!
What is that, chewing wood?
Yeah!
I don't know why you do what you do. All I know is that my house is a mess!
Logger Vic, why would we destroy your house like that?
Then tell me, where do these teeth marks come from?
Teeth marks? They look pretty small. Nah, I think you made a mistake here, Vic. These aren't bear teeth, huh?
Logger Vic, look. Bear's bite marks are much smoother. Like that, see?
Oh, you're right. I can see that. I'm sorry. I have accused you falsely.
Huh?
Well then, I'm gonna go find out who the real culprit is.
Bram, come on. Huh? Let's go help.
Yeah.
Logger Vic!
Oh? Hey Vic, we'll help you investigate.
Oh, thanks. That's real nice of you.
And gotcha!
Huh?
Huh. Where could he be hiding?
I'm gonna turn this place inside out till I find you. Hmm? Wah! Huh? Sleeping at a time like this, you lazy cat! Fabian, wake up! You're a terrible security cat! Someone trashed the house! Fabian! Forget it. Just go back to sleep. I don't even know why I keep that lazy cat around.
I got it!
You found the home wrecker?
Huh?
So where is it?
Come on, come on. Let us have a look, Bramble.
And it better compensate.
I just found a steamed bun, that's all.
What? Steamed bun? Boy.
Hey, Vic, do you think maybe I could have this steamed bun? What do you say?
Vic, you're the nicest guy! You're so
Logger Vic, found this little frog in your shoe. Know anything about it?
Hey, that was one of my favorite toys as a little boy.
Is that little thing even any fun?
Most definitely.
Oh, here it comes!
Go. Boy, this is
I've
fun.
Never seen such a lively toy. Oh, I'm
It sure is something. Am I forgetting something important?
The homewrecker!
You hear that? Now, is it that suspicious? It's a hamster!
Hamster? Those bite marks must belong to him.
You betcha! That's the homewrecker right there!
It's adorable!
Logger Vic! Grab him!
Come here, you! Stop!
Get him!
Don't move! Catch
it. Don't move! There he goes! Get him!
I'm safe!
So you really think you're safe, huh? Well, guess again! I'm a tree climbing pro!
Watch out!
You've been a pretty naughty little hamster.
You gotta be more careful.
I got you now.
Let me go! Let me go! Let me go!
Briar, ask him why he was chewing on my furniture.
So, why'd you chew the furniture, huh?
Briar, don't be mean. He's just a little guy.
He wasn't mean. I didn't mean to scare him.
Just stop it. We better ask him when he comes to.
I didn't do it on purpose. It's just that my teeth itched.
Oh, the little hamster said his teeth itch, so he can't help biting.
Can't help biting, eh? Is that really true?
Itchy teeth. Oh. Hey, little guy. Open your mouth for me. I'll check your teeth, okay?
Don't be afraid. Briar is a nice bear.
He's teething. It's no wonder he wants to bite things.
Well, that explains that. Logger Vic, the hamster didn't do it on purpose. Won't you forgive him, huh?
Yeah, it's wrong. He won't bring my stuff back. Why is he crying?
He says the living conditions here are terrible.
Huh?
The wood's no good, the bed's too hard, and he doesn't even have a private toilet. So he just wants to go home.
Oh, dear. Of course it's no good. This place isn't suitable.
Well, where does he live?
He says train station.
The train station?
What's that? Hardly wait to get home. So I can sleep for a week. I know where he lives. I'll take him back right now. Come on.
It's raining cats and dogs out there. Looks like you need to stay one more night, little guy.
Stop biting my sofa! Hey, stop that! Hey, a little help over here, please.
That little hamster is too fast. What else can we do?
I'm exhausted.
Oh, no. No. If he keeps going, my house will be ruined. My couch, my blanket, even my windows. Just stop biting! The biting! Oh, the biting! It was just a dream. That was terrible. That little hamster had me freaking out all night. The rain stopped. Fantastic! He has to go!
Hey, Briar, give me another log. Briar!
I'm up. Man, what did you say, bro? I did not get a good sleep last night. Man, I'm beat.
Gee, Logger Vic sure looked motivated. And it was nice of him to prepare these logs. You know what? I think he liked the little hamster after all. Ain't that right?
I just want him home as fast as possible. We're here!
Home sweet home!
Aw, how sweet! Let's go home so we can get some sleep too. Our bear cave is the most comfortable place.
Logger Vic! Logger Vic!
Detective Bramble, Part 2. My honey jar! My honey jar! It's not here! Oh, let me check here. Where has it gone to? My sweet honey!
Hey, Bramble. Why so sad? We can get you some more, okay?
Something's wrong here. Briar, we're the only ones who knew where that jar was.
Briar, was it you?
Easy, let's not get mad. But, I hid the honey, so that you would have a case to solve. I can show you right where I put it.
Huh?
Look, I left it right here. I'm as surprised as you are. Somebody must have stole it. Why would they do that? I can't believe it. Oh, man. Huh?
Bro, I'll solve this mystery.
Bramble, how in the world did you change clothes so quickly?
A detective never reveals his skills. That's what makes us the best at solving crimes in the most secretive way possible. Call me Detective Bramble.
Welcome back, Detective Bramble.
From the tracks left here, I can tell it was dug up with professional tools. Look, and these, there's only one thing they could be. These are human footprints.
Human?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got it. There's only one human I know who lives in this forest. Huh? So that makes it pretty obvious who stole my honey jar. Logger Vic!
Achoo! Oh, I wonder what that could be.
Logger Vic! Open up! Open the door!
I'm
Logger
coming.
Vic! Open the door!
Keep your pants on!
Open the door, Logger Vic!
What are you doing here this early? Huh? What are you two doing? I didn't invite you.
Just give it to me, okay?
I'm sorry? Give you what?
You know what?
Hey, Bramble. Remember, you're a detective.
Oh,
be cool. I'll go check inside his room.
Here's the thing, Vic. One of our honey jars has gone missing, and I think it was you who stole it.
Honey? What would I want with your honey?
Oh, Vic, don't get mad. We saw human footprints at the crime scene, and so we just want to take a little look.
You bears are gonna pay if you don't find anything.
I'm very confident about my skills.
Bramble, I searched everywhere, but I couldn't find it.
You stink of bears! Get out of here right now!
Don't get it, bro. If Logger Vic didn't take it, then who else could it be? I can't stand it!
Come on, bro, just relax. I'm thinking. There must be some more clues.
Briar, look! Look at those small holes.
Huh? Let me see. Huh? I don't remember seeing those before. This must have happened today.
Then I bet it was the thief who made them. Let me think. Oh, yeah, I know who did it!
Huh?
What do you guys want?
Herbert, you stole our honey jar, didn't you?
No. I promise it wasn't me.
Tell the truth. Don't make us use another method.
Easy, bro. There's no need for all of that.
Oh, I know.
I promise it wasn't me. I'm telling the truth.
All right, bro, stop. It's not worth it. If he had taken it, he'd have told us.
I don't know who took the honey jar, but I did see something strange last night.
Oh, really? I apologize for the tickling. I didn't mean it. Herbert, won't you forgive me? And please, tell me who stole my honey jar.
Just tell him. He's really eager to solve this case.
Okay, listen carefully. Last night, I was burrowing underground to repair my house. You know, add some rooms, whatever. I was going about my business when suddenly I heard someone digging nearby. And so, I went to check who it was. And you know who it was?
Tell us!
It was you! What? What'd I do?
Yeah, you're right. When you saw me, I was burying it.
Oh, Briar, your digging skills, they're not really professional. Totally amateur. If you'd ask me to help you, I'd...
Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Focus, okay? What happened after I left?
Oh, sorry, Briar. Let me think. Yeah, that's right. So I worked a little bit longer on the house, and then I felt tired, so I went home to sleep. Yeah, that's it.
But you didn't see anybody else?
Not a soul.
You're lying to us!
Ah, Bramble, easy there.
I'm telling the truth!
Calm down, Bramble.
Oh, wait, I remember something.
Then tell us.
I remember when I was about to sleep, I heard somebody digging in the ground again. I was quite sleepy at that point, so I wasn't sure if it was Briar or someone else.
How is this a good clue? Can't you tell us anything else?
Hey, I'm getting there. Just hold your horses. Even though I didn't see anything clearly, I smelt some kind of really strong fragrance.
You're sure?
Oh, yeah. It was disgusting.
Some kind of fragrance? Only humans wear that stuff. Well, it's clear now. It has to be Logger Vic who took it.
When we were at his house, I noticed something. There was a shovel covered in dirt. What's more, looked like the same kind of dirt.
I knew it. It was Logger Vic for sure. I bet he hid the jar. Okay, let's go pay him a visit.
Yeah, time to get our honey back.
Vic, good luck.
Logger Vic, open up.
Hey, you two bears, sup? I haven't done anything wrong. In fact, I haven't been logging or stealing or doing anything of that nature.
You're lying to us. Come here and look.
I didn't know you could draw. Hey, cool, man.
Focus, Vic. Have you ever seen this honey jar before?
No, I haven't seen anything at all. Okay. I saw it last night.
Goodbye, precious jar. Hope this works.
Precious jar? Yes. I found it. Come to Papa. What's this? How's it precious? I'm not sure. It's, well, pretty ugly. Absolutely worth nothing to me. Waste of time. Back to work, I guess.
Is that true? Hmm? You didn't take the jar?
My honor as a logger, I did not take that jar of yours. Besides, what would I do with a jar like that? Worthless. And you know me, I like the good things in life.
Okay, I guess it wasn't him.
Then who could it be?
I am hearing that Logger Vic isn't the one that be stealing your precious jar.
Then who took it?
Hold on, I'm thinking here.
Let's look at it again. Maybe there are some more clues. Huh? Look, these are some interesting footprints.
Even though I didn't see anything clearly, I smelt some kind of really strong fragrance.
You sure?
Some kind of fragrance? Only humans wear that stuff. Well, it's clear now. It had to be Logger Vic who took it.
I figured out who did it.
Huh?
The thief is one of us.
Huh? Just telling us, Briar. Kids like me cannot waiting all day.
If you must know, it's you.
Huh? What? Who? It was not me, no way.
It was you.
How could it be me? I am the king. A king does not steal anything.
Yeah, he's right. Tiki definitely wouldn't do something like that.
Briar, maybe you made a mistake.
Huh? You really want to see my proof? Come on, I'll show it to you. Herbert, come sniff it. Is this the same fragrance you smelled?
Yeah. Oh, that smells disgusting.
Herbert, watching your words now? Do you think your kid smells bad? You be telling me?
Well...
it was him! It was him!
That's it? The case has been solved.
Just a funny. This smell cannot prove anything. And you know, my scent is used by almost every animal in the forest.
You said it.
What about the footprints? Logger Vic left shoe prints. But you don't wear shoes. So the other footprints have to be yours.
Where being you proving? My footprints no meaning are taking.
Fine. I'll show you how I proved it.
Oh, aren't those honeybees?
Watch this. Ta-da!
Okay, I admitting the thief was me. Oh, my dear. I know it's bad. I'm such a baddie. Please forgive me. I know not why I do this.
Yeah! Briar!
Nothing.
That's my brother. He's my hero. Huh?
Wait.
It was supposed to be Detective Bramble! Detective Bramble was supposed to solve the case.
Bramble's Bug Buddies.
Where is this place? Maybe I'm a little lost. Oh.
La la la! Do do da! Yippity bitty bitty bitty! Working under the moonlight is the best thing ever! With her just up there! And the fresh air down here. It's just so good. Get away! Stop bothering me! It's just not fair. What a nuisance!
It sure is dark out here tonight, huh? Who's that? I'll tell you one thing. This is the last time I come out for food on nights like this. Oh, man. What was that? Who's there? I must be imagining things. It's a ghost! You can have my stash of honey and all my toys. Just please don't eat me, Mr. Ghost. I'm too young to get eaten. Whoa. It's itty bitty glow flies. Firefly!
What was that? Let's go check. Come on.
So, how do you like that? Not bugging me anymore, are ya?
Logger Vic!
Blob!
That spray smells like poison! No! Wait, stay with me! Don't go! Bug Buddy! Wait, come back!
Boy, oh boy, this toilet water sure does work great!
What'd he say?
That Logger Vic. First he cuts our trees, now he's spraying toxic water too?
I won't let you little cuties suffer.
Not on my watch!
Logger Vic! Stop!
Stop, no! Leave me alone!
Logger Vic!
Serves you right, big boy. Catch you later.
Hey, it's you guys. I'm sorry. I said I'd stop Vic, but then I let him get away. All forgiven then? Thanks! Oh, guys, slow down! Wait for me! Ooh, what? This is so much fun! Guys, come down! Play with me! I can't fly!
Woo!
Woo-wee! Yeah! Yeah! Wow! I've decided you little guys and I will be best friends forever. Huh? A chainsaw.
Hear that? There's no more mosquitoes near me. Chubbity chop 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 chop! Quah!
Looks like he's up to no good. Gotta think.
Come on, Bramble.
Oh, yeah!
Who's there? Just my imagination. Go away!
That's right, keep running.
Wow. Look at that. Help me. Whatever you say, don't eat me.
I've seen what you do to this forest at night. As guardian spirit, it's my duty to punish bad guys like you.
Please, my boss is the one responsible. He makes me cut down all the lumber. What if I could pay you? Oh dear, I've got one more coin. Is it enough? Oh, please take it and have mercy on me.
Oh, good idea. Ooh, bring me honey.
Honey? Ghost the honey? That's funny. Oh, this is weird. Alrighty, I'll get you the honey.
Oh, good, good, perfect. Honey.
Let me wait on here. It's just a bunch of fireflies. Who's playing tricks on me? Come on, come and face me.
Now run home and bring me honey. Woo! Oh, man, he really fell for it. And now, sweet honey all for me. Huh? Logger Vic? Where'd he go? Logger Vic!
Look, get back there! I'm gonna get you!
I'm doomed! Briar, come save me!
You're on your own today. Go away!
Hey, Vic, I'm over here! Leave my firefly friends alone!
Great! Gotcha!
No!
I said freeze!
Huh? A hole! Oh no! I'm stuck!
Now. Oh!
Back here, get me!
Oh yeah! Oh, you bears never learn. You think you're real funny, don't you?
Goodbye, cruel world! I'm done for! I'm okay!
Hey,
it was you guys?
You come back here with that right now! My head.
Logger Vic! Good luck with that! Thank you guys for saving me. I can't imagine what Logger Vic would have done to me. I'm so lucky to have you guys as friends. Oh! Oh!